I hope you had a chance to look at this problem. It's an excellent example that illustrates how a general acid and a general base can work together to carry out some reactions like nucleophile addition to a polarized pi bond or beta elimination. What we want to do in each step is to use the pyridine, that's the neutral heterocyclic, benzene-looking-like heterocyclic, that's going to function as a general base, and the conjugate acid of that, pyridinium, is going to function as a general acid. Notice that in every box there's a pyridine and a pyridinium. And if we just track one of those groups, let's track the top one, that top pyridine becomes a pyridinium. It functioned as a general base, picking up a proton and making the conjugate acid of that base. In going from box 2 to box 3, that pyridinium serves as a general acid, donating its proton and becoming the neutral pyridine. And finally, in box 3 to box 4, that neutral pyridine is going to function as a general base, picking up a proton and returning to the pyridinium case. You can track that lower pyridine, and it's going to always be doing just the opposite. So it's going to initially function as a general acid, giving up its proton, becoming a general base. That creates a base. It's going to pick up a proton and become pyridinium. That pyridinium is going to function as a general acid, giving up its proton and becoming neutral. The point is that by having this shuttle back and forth between this pyridine and pyridinium, the reaction never has to encounter a very large change in pKa. In fact, it's isoenergetic in that there's just this ping-pong effect where a proton is hopping from pyridine to pyridinium and vice versa, pyridinium to pyridine, and so there's never any major change in energy associated with a big change in putting a proton on an unlikely position. All right, let's work through the first step. I'm not going to work through all of these steps for you, but I just want to show how you can get started. The highlighted carbon, the tetrahedral intermediate, used to be that carbonyl carbon there, and so you can see we've made a new bond. That new bond is this carbon to nitrogen bond. We've broken what was the carbonyl group. The carbonyl double bond has now gotten transformed into a carbon-oxygen single bond. And along the way, we picked up a proton, and so the carbonyl oxygen must become protonated. We can pretty much guess that that proton is going to be delivered from the pyridinium cation. Now, if we look at the nitrogen group, the nitrogen atom that adds into the carbonyl is almost certainly going to be that nitrogen. And if you notice, it had two hydrogens on it, and now, down on the bottom, it only has the one. So one of these hydrogens must have been lost, and it must have been lost to the base that probably is the pyridine. And in fact, we can use that idea to get us started. In every one of these steps, in fact, you're going to see that we always start our curved arrows from the general base, and we always end our curved arrows by depositing an electron to the general acid. So we're going to start with the general base, we're going to end with the general acid. That's always the way the electrons will flow. We're going to use this general base to remove that proton, activating that nitrogen as a nucleophile, which can do the ADN step, nucleophile addition to a polarized pi bond. As that bond begins to form and the pi bond begins to break, we're going to use that pair of electrons to pick up the proton that will be on the carbonyl oxygen. That bond is going to be broken, and we'll have a neutral pyridine formed as a consequence. The result of those curved arrows end up making the structure that's shown here, and you can follow them for yourself, and then go ahead and try to turn this around by starting with the pair of electrons on the neutral pyridine and flowing them all the way through back up to this pyridine cation. Keep going over that process. Eventually you'll get to the point where you need to draw this intermediate, and you should be able to do that now, thinking through with this combination of pyridine serving as a general base, pyridinium simultaneously serving as a general acid.